In this video, we will do the marking and cutting for the pencil fit pen. First, mark a line at the bottom to straighten the cloth. Then, mark another line 2 inches away from the bottom. This is for the bottom. The length is 38 inches. We will minus 1 inch, which will give us 37 inches. We will mark at 37. Mark at 9 inches for the crotch. It is a standard one. Mark at 12 inches from the crotch marking for the knee. This is also a standard one. Now join the markings by drawing a line. The strikeout line is wrong. Mark at 7.5 inches at the bottom. This is the center point of the leg, which is a standard for a normal people. If the man is little bit fat, you may consider increasing 1 to 2 inches. Mark at 7.5 at all the markings. The bottom is 13 inches. We will divide it by 4. We get 3.25 inches. Mark at 3.25 on both sides from the center point. Knee is 16 inches. We will divide it by 4. We get 4 inches. Mark at 4 on both sides from the center point. Thigh is 22 inches. We'll divide it by 4, we get 5.5 inches. Mark at 5.5 on both sides from the center point. Mark 1/2 inch on both sides inside the thigh marking. Mark at 2 inches for the zipper opening. The hip is 32. We will divide it by 4, we get 8 inches. From the center point, mark at 3 inches on the right side and mark at 8 on the left one. Join the zipper marking of hip and thigh by a straight line. Join all the markings as shown. Waist is 35, divided by 4 we get 8¾ plus half inch for stitching, total 9¼ inches. Mark it on the center between the thigh and hip. Now we will mark the back part of the pant. Place the front piece of the pant over the cloth. Extend the markings of bottom, knee and all the other markings on the cloth. On the top, draw a slant line which should be 1 inch away to the right corner. This is to make a perfect round around hip. If you don't give this, the person on your back can see your buttocks, which is not a pretty, which is not a pretty sight, I can tell you. Mark half for the stitching at the top and mark another half to give dot at the back part of the pant for the perfect round. Hip is 32, we will divide it by 4, we get 8 inches plus half for stitching, then mark at 8.5 inches. We will give 1.5 inches extra in case if the belly becomes large. You can give loosing by removing the stitch and stitching it again based on the width. Waist is 35, we'll divide it by 4, we get 8.75. We'll add 1/2 inch for stitching, which is total 9.25 inches. Mark at 9.25, center to the hip and thigh. Mark 1.5 inches on the right side for the thigh. The back part of the thigh should be 1.5 to 2 inches extra than the front part. It is solely based on the appearance of the person. Mark 1.5 inches on the right side for the knee. Then mark 1.25 inches on the right side of the bottom. The thigh should be up to 2 inches extra, the knee should be 1.5 inches and the bottom should be 1.25 inches extra than the front part. Join the markings using the bent scale. Mark a slant line at the waist marking at the back part of the pant. Draw a curve from the marking as shown. We will do the cutting now. In the next part, we will iron the pant pieces. Thanks for watching.